STG Repairs has served our customers since 2008 in Miami. STG Repairs team fixes almost all smartphones, tablets, and computers on the market. It also specializes in board-level repairs. Troubleshoot board-level problems. No touchscreen function, no backlight, no power. Replace knocked-off SMD components on any board. Problems with water and other liquid damage, and charging problems. We also do factory unlock, software errors, data transfer, and recovery. We have a very solid reputation in the repair community. Our clients can count on our experience. Our goal is reliable service and competitive prices.
Okay, right now we are going to talk about, I have an iPhone 6 that is not turning on, okay? Vamos a hablar de un iPhone 6 que no está encendiendo. Lo primero que hice fue inspeccionarlo, que luego le voy a enseñar el board. Tenía un tornillo atravesado. Cuando chequeé, cuando raspé el tornillo atravesado, no había hecho ningún daño. So, automáticamente descarté el problema del tornillo atravesado. The first thing I did, that later I'm going to show you under the microscope, well, it has a long screw damage, but once I make the inspection, the damage, was not significant. Okay, so now what I did is, I just connect the board to the charging port. Lo que hice fue ahora conectar el board al charging port, al conector de carga, y quiero medir en el positivo de la batería. Y como ven, me marca 2.8. Usualmente, aquí debe marcarme 3.7 o 4. Okay. The first thing I did was connect the charging port, connector, put some power, and just checking on the positive of the connector, the battery connector. And there, I'm supposed to get at least 3.7, 4.0, and I'm just getting 2.9. So, this means I'm having a short on the board. Okay, next thing, I'm going to move to a thermal camera. So you're going to see where is the board getting hot. Lo próximo que vamos a hacer, vamos a movernos a la cámara termal y van a ver dónde se nos está calentando. Okay, now, let me put the, okay. You can see there, yeah, okay. That's the board. Just put power. I'm sorry, just connect the charging port. And you can see there, the CPU is getting extremely hot. When I touch it, it's very, very hot. So now, what I'm doing is just going to check the back part. Como vieron, se calienta en esa parte del CPU. Y entonces ahora voy a checar la parte de atrás y podemos observar que el PMIC se está calentando. ¿Ok? Como ven, es exactamente ahí donde está calentando. Y si toco, puedo sentir que la NAND también se está calentando. You can see we have the PMIC. It's getting hot. We have a short. And I can feel the NAND. That is getting, the PMIC is getting extremely, extremely hot. Okay? So, let me see now. Let me just connect this so we can have a picture. Continue. Vamos a continuar. Solo tomé una foto. Y entonces, ¿qué encontré? Ok. Primero. Lo primero que vamos a hacer es, si se acuerdan, ok, the first thing that we're going to do, if you guys remember, I just want you to guys see the CXW. Quiero que vean el software de ZXW. Okay, quiero que observen el software de ZXW. Okay, right here. Okay, if you guys remember the thermal camera, what I did was, you can remember the area when I have the short, the PEMIG was getting super hot, was a start around this area. Okay, so the first thing I do, I just check. I just want to know what lines are near to this. Lo primero que hago es chequear. Quiero saber qué líneas son las que están aquí cerca. Ok, de esta manera encuentro el corto más rápido usando la lógica. Ok, I just use my logic. So what I did, I just went here. I just want to check each of this line just from the bottom. I know it's just around here. So when I click here, I realize here we have the 3 volts NAND. PP3B09. Okay. Cuando cliqueo aquí, me doy cuenta que aquí en el PMIC tengo la línea de PP3B09. Okay. Inmediatamente sé que aquí va a estar el error. Automáticamente, cuando vi eso, sabía que aquí era donde iba a tener el problema. So, the first thing I did when I saw that, I just went to my multimeter and take the board. And when I do this, let me change. No, you know, I don't have. Let me change the camera. Let me see if you guys can. No. Let me change this camera because we're not going to need the. No, yeah, let's just do it. Okay. Let's do it there. Okay. If. See, we have. Now we're going to put night mode. Okay, let me change this. Okay. So I just going to check the capacitor, any capacitor on the line, the PP3B09, which is going to be right there. I can clearly see we have a short. Let me just check again. Let me transfer you to the image so you guys can see what I'm doing now. Let's see if you can see clearly there. Yes, okay. I just wanna touch ground, black and ground. Red and ground. And with the black one in dial mode, we are going to test the capacitors. Okay, el negro lo tengo, disculpa, el rojo lo tengo en tierra y el negro en modo de diodo. Vamos a tocar el capacitor. Como ven, toco ahí y toco aquí. Ok, aquí sí está en ground, sí debería estar en ground. Here is supposed to be ground, which is fine, but here is where we have the 3B09 line. Aquí es donde tenemos la línea del PP3B09. So, está a tierra. Esto nos indica automáticamente que ahí tenemos el corte. Ok. Y podemos ver, cuando yo observé más, ya detenidamente encontré que definitivamente, voy a subir la imagen más clara, una foto, y podemos ver que el problema es este capacitor que está rajado. Okay, we can clearly see that capacitor is damaged. Okay, let me see if I can show more. The first one, C0634. So let's check if it's true that removing that capacitor, we're going to remove the short. Vamos a ver si es verdad que removiendo ese capacitor vamos a resolver el problema. Está rajado. Se puede ver que está rajado. So let's check. Okay, now let's remove this. I'm just going to cover a little bit the LAN. You don't have to use heat if you don't want it. Let me see if you guys can see there. Okay. Have to remove the little bit the side of the because it has another coating there. I was trying just to move it without removing the coating, but I will have to remove the coating first. Estaba planeando sacarlo sin quitar el coating, pero está bien pegadito. Vamos a quitar el coating primero. Ahí está. Para que salga más fácil. Okay. Now we are going to remove it. Flux. Piece of flux. And then we are just going to remove it. Now it's going to be faster because we removed the coating already, so we're not going to have too much issue there. Okay. So we remove the capacitor. Turn on this. Removemos el capacitor, que está en corto. Vamos a limpiar un momentito. Antes de volverlo a probar, I'm going to just clean the pad a little bit before testing again. Okay. And now we're going to see if the short is not pressing anymore. Okay, vamos a chequear a ver si el corto ya no está presente. Como pueden observar, ya aquí en este lado no suena y aquí sí suena. Ok. Let's see if you guys can see there. Yeah, this is where we were testing. Perfect. The short is no present anymore. So let's see if we can change the cameras again. This is the chat plus, which is very good. And let's see if now we are able to do this up. Okay. See our string here. Okay, the first thing we are going to do, we're going to make the test again. Lo primero que vamos a hacer es hacer el test que hicimos al principio. Right there. Voltage. And let's see. On the positive, as you guys can see, we have 4 voltage, 3.9. So now we know we are going to be fine. Okay, perfect. Let's test it. Como vemos, ya tenemos los 4 de 3.7, 4 voltios. Y creemos que ahora sí vamos a haber resuelto el problema. Ah, I forget to show you. This is This is the long screw that I check. Okay, este es el long screw que chequeé, pero estaba en buenas condiciones. No había pasado, no había pasado. So, let me see here. We are going to test it very quick. We have the battery, it's showing on the image. Okay, let me bring another battery. Because this is dead, I have another battery here. Vamos a probar otra batería porque esta está aparentemente descargada. I'm gonna test with another battery. Okay. But it is also okay, right here. Como ven, ya pensé que la batería también está descargada, pero parece que esta sí tiene un poquito de carga. Okay, so let's see if this phone is going to turn on. So we found the short on the PP3B09. Encontramos el corto en la línea PP3B09. Vamos a ver. Ya podemos escuchar que está encendiendo. We can hear that it's going to turn on. Is right there. Okay, so we can see is, let me see if we have the password for this phone. We have no password, so we cannot go inside the phone to put more bright on the screen. Okay, pero ya tenemos encendido el teléfono y lo más seguro solamente que hay que, como ven, está encendido, tenemos que quitarle el paso. Okay, so this is how we resolve it short on the PP3B09 for iPhone 6. Esto es la manera como le quitamos el corto a un iPhone 6 que tenía en el PP3B09. Okay, so thank you.